Actually, it's quite simple, you know. In painting, it's all about the right color on the right place. But it took me years to find out exactly what color and in what place. I was 10 years old when my parents sent me to classes, drawing classes, which was for me the escape of going to school. School for me was a prison. And with these drawing courses, I was really happy. I've been there 10 years. It sounds amazing, but I went there three times a week doing drawing, still lifes, portrait drawing, figure anatomy, all these things that you have to go through. And at the age of 19, I think, I went to art school, but that was in the 70s. And in the 70s, it's not really interesting if you're a good draftsman or not. It must be abstract, or you have to be an artist more than a draftsman that I could. So I got lost there. But these beginning years, these 10 years of classes, they are the fundament of what I'm doing. When you're 30 years old, you're too young for a portrait. And when you pass the 50 years, then it's becoming. And when now I'm 60 years old, I feel that I'm young enough to do a good portrait. Painting a portrait is not only painting the picture, it's the celebration of a person. And in my portraits, I don't look for that much drama on the canvas. That what you see nowadays with American portrait painters. There is a lot of dramatic light. For me, there is no much drama more than the person. You don't have to exaggerate. I work from photography because I'm looking for that split second that you feel okay, the sitter and me at the same time. If you do, for instance, this portrait, you can't do from sitting, because this is the very single moment of all these 50 photographs that I took, the one that I'm happy with, the one you can paint. And I'm convinced, well, I can't do this from life. I have to rely on photography, because this is the face, and slightly later then it changes, or he changes, or these hands, or all these things. And you can't ask people to sit there for hours in this position. On the other hand, my clients come from all Europe. I can't travel with my easel hanging on my neck and do the thing in the sitter's home. My experience was, and I don't know if it's valid still, but in Holland, it seems that people want to show who they are. And in Spain, sometimes you see that the client wants to show what he has. But in general, it doesn't matter at all. The problem is doing my job in several countries, that you have to talk with the people. And I'm Dutch, so I can help myself in English. But in French, I can't. So going to France is for me more difficult, because I have to talk to the sitter. If I can't talk to the sitter, there is no contact. Going abroad, language is very important for me. If you don't speak the language, I think you can't make a portrait. We went to Spain 20 years ago because Helma, my wife, she could have a sabbatical leave in the art school where she was teaching sculpture. Friends of ours, they offered their house in Valencia in Spain, and we came to Spain for 1 year, and we stayed another year, and that was too long, so we happened to stay. I think moving from Holland to Spain, there was a sort of going backwards in time. Moving from Valencia to Chelva also was a sort of moving backwards in time. I didn't see that from the beginning, that we were looking for a simple life. But now we are living here in Chelva. I really love the simple life that we are able to do. We walk a lot in the mountains. We grow our own crops, that's mostly Helma does. Well, I always thought that I was doing my job as a hobby or my hobby as a job. I never considered myself as an artist. Although it sounds stupid, I'd rather think of myself as a craftsman. I always wanted to be a carpenter, you know, until my mother said, you can do more. I didn't want to do anything more. Doing portraits, for me, is sort of making a good chair. I love teaching portrait painting that I do in summer courses in France. It's a lot of fun to teach people what materials to use. I mean, you can't teach them how to draw, that takes a lifetime. But talking about problems you meet using the good canvas, good brushes, good color, good medium, and these tiny little things are very useful for the beginning students. Teaching I can't do here in Spain, because in Spain, in my studio, I'm a painter, I'm not a teacher. So I have to go to France, and there I'm able to be a teacher, and here I'm a painter. If you travel a lot for your commission work to England, Holland, or France, or Germany, whatever, I'm happy when I'm home again, in the quiet hills of Chelva, where my studio is. I close the door, and there I find my eternal tools, my brushes, and my paint.